As we come to the concluding message, the Lord is telling us he's sending rain, he's sending showers, he's sending blessing, he's sending the supernatural exploits from glory, and he's sending it upon the earth, all the nations of the earth, all the countries in the world, and every locality, every local government, every region, every state, every community in the whole world, I will send rain upon the earth. But the children of Israel at this time, they were neither here nor there. And so God had to challenge them. Look at verse 20. In verse 20, it says, so Ahab sent unto all the children of Israel, and he gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. Verse 21, and Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him, but if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. They couldn't answer. They didn't understand that the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, that God was still alive. They had gone into worshiping Baal, and it had been terrible for them because they were halting between two opinions. And the Lord is telling us tonight, make up your mind and make your choice and understand that the God of heaven, he says, I am God, I change not, and that Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Lord, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And then as you come to the side of the Lord, there are going to be showers for you. Look at verse 45. In verse 45, it says, and it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great rain. It happened then, it's going to happen now. A great rain. But then the Lord is making an appeal tonight. The message is divine appeal to seekers of showers of blessing. God is asking, what do you stand? What do you believe? What do you understand? Do you know that problem you are brought in today, the Lord is going to clear it away? That sickness, the Lord is going to clear it away? That mountain is going to move tonight? All those things that have brought sorrow in your life, that everything tonight is going to be solved. And he's appealing to you. And he's saying, don't be of two opinions here and there. Come and center your mind and your faith on the Almighty, the one that never fails. And tonight, miracle in your spirit, in your soul, in your body, and in your life, in your family, in Jesus' name. Deuteronomy chapter 30. We're reading from verse 19. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. I call heaven and earth to record this day against you, that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life. The choice is yours. There's healing, there's sickness, choose healing. The sin, the salvation, choose salvation. The sadness, there's gladness, choose gladness. There is evil, there is good, choose good. There is blessing and there is cursing, choose blessing. There is life and there is death, choose life, that both thou and thy seed may live. I come to announce to you the decision of heaven concerning you. You will live. Eternal life, abundant life, heavenly life, supernatural life, a life that one will not be cut short. You will live in Jesus' name. Divine appeal to seekers of showers of blessing. Tonight, there are three things we're talking about. Number one, halting. Number two, hearing. Number three, healing. You move from halting unto hearing, and as you hear well tonight, you are going to hear well. Then healing will follow. I am healed. I am healed. Number one, halting between two opinions and suffering. The children of Israel were halting here, there, between two opinions, and they were suffering. On Sunday, some people come to their church, to their service. They're looking up to the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. On Monday, they are back to their idols. They are halting. And while you're halting like that, there is suffering. Halting between two opinions and suffering. Number two, hearing with thoughtful observation and surrendering. As Elijah came, Elijah said, we're going to put these gods to a test. And the prophets of Baal, let them put their sacrifice, but put no fire under. And then I will bring the sacrifice, no fire under. Let them pray. There are very many, more than 450. And it says, when they pray, if that Baal is able to bring fire, then we know that it has power. But if it does not have the power to bring the fire down, I alone, think about that. One man, Elijah, with the word of God, with the spirit of God, with the power of God, with the assurance from God, I alone, I will pray. And then the God that answers by fire, he will be your God. And so they heard with thoughtful observation, and they surrendered all the regalia and all the things of idol worship. And what happens? Number three, healing from the truly obedient, for the truly obedient supplicant. As you supplicate, as you pray, as you call on the God of heaven, and you know this is the only God, the God of salvation, and the God of our healing, the God of our redemption, and the God that works miracles even till today. Today, miracle will come upon your life. Healing, total healing. In your spirit, in your soul, in your mind, in your body, in your family, in your project, in your profession, in everything you set your hand on, the Lord will knock the hand of the devil away from your life completely in Jesus' name. Healing for the truly obedient supplicant. Now we're coming to number one. Number one, halting between two opinions and suffering. While they were halting between two opinions, okay, I come to the crusade, and then after the crusade, I go back to my religion. I come to the crusade, and after the crusade, I go back to the papa who used to put charms for me. I will come to the crusade. After the crusade, I will go to those people that will give me something to drink and something to swallow. I will go to the crusade. After the crusade, I'll go to those people that will give me something to rub halting between two opinions. Look at that again in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 21. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt ye between two opinions? You have been dilly-dallying. You have been going here and going there. You have been seeking here and seeking there. You have been halting between two opinions for how many years now, and you're still suffering. You have been halting two opinions for all these many years, and you're not saved. You have been halting two opinions all these long time, and your life is not settled. Your family is not settled. That's why the Lord is asking you, how long? How long? If you have been going on a road for a long time and you didn't get your destination, why don't you turn back and say, there's no salvation there. I've been there a long time, and there is no healing there, and there's no rest of mind there, and there's no unity of family. There's nothing there that establishes and then brings blessing upon your family. I've been going that long road a long time, and it has not profited me. I come back. As you come back, something good will happen in your life. How long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. They couldn't make up their mind. What do we do? Tradition has been for a long time, and tradition has made an inroad into our lives. Religious tradition, superficial tradition, superstitious tradition, and the native tradition. We follow here, and then there's no way. Look at these people in 2 Kings chapter 17. I'm reading from verse 9. 2 Kings chapter 17, we're reading from verse 9. It says, and the children of Israel did secretly do things which were not right against the Lord their God. You know, there are people, talk like Christians on Sunday, and they behave like Christians on Sunday. They sit gently there on Sunday, and everything appears to be all right. But secretly, they think, they act, they do, they behave, they practice secret things that were not right against the Lord their God. Look at verse 33. In verse 33, they feared the Lord and served their own gods. They said, I fear the Lord. I believe the Lord. Pastor, let me tell you, I've been baptized in water as an infant. They feared the Lord. I have baptismal certificate. They feared the Lord. They say they take the Holy Communion in their assembly, but secretly they're still doing evil. They feared the Lord and served their own gods, their family gods, their tribal gods, their national gods. They feared the Lord externally. Eternally, they served their own gods after the manner of the nations whom they carried away from things. Verse 34, it says, unto this day, these people say, I'm religious, I know birth in the Bible, I have two Bibles, three Bibles in my house, yet unto this day, they do after their former manners, they fear not the Lord. They fear the Lord, but not with their heart. They don't have experience of salvation. They don't honor the Lord. They don't believe in the Lord. And so the Lord said, they fear not the Lord, neither do they after their statutes or after their ordinances or after the law and the commandment which the Lord commanded the children of Jacob, whom he named Israel. Look there at verse 40. In verse 40, it says, howbeit they did not hearken. They have been at the crusade, they did not hearken. They think just coming to the crusade, that's all. But then they're still halting between two opinions. But they did after their former manners. The smoking of the past, still there. The drunkenness of the past, still there. The adultery, fornication of the past, still there. The stealing of the past is still there. The fighting, the violence of the past is still there. The cruelty of the past is still there. They do after their former manners. Then in verse 41, it says, so these nations feared the Lord and served their graven images. Look at that. These nations feared the Lord. It says, our national religion is Christianity. And so they do all the things that Christianity has brought to them. They observe the Christmas and the Easter and the harvest time and the religious things and the religious songs. And then they quote some Bible. They even memorize some verses of the Bible. But these nations fear the Lord and serve their graven images, both their children and their children's children. As did their fathers, so do they. Those are the people, they are halting between two opinions. But today, you will not halt. Are you here? You will not halt. Halting is taken away from you in Jesus' name. And then you make up your mind, you say, Christ is my Savior. Every day of my life, Christ is my Lord. And every time, anywhere I find myself, I live according to my conviction that I am born again, I am converted, I'm a child of God. I'm not talking between two opinions. I will not call anymore in Jesus' name. Look at Jeremiah chapter 2, reading from verse 13. Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 13. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewed them out cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water. That can hold no water. Check up your life. Why don't you make up your mind and say, this God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, is the one I will serve. I will not turn here and turn there. I will remain with the Lord. And then all the calamities of the past will be taken away from your life in Jesus' name. Tonight, I said tonight will be the night of your redemption. You will come out of Egypt and you will come out of every spell, every calamity that the Egyptian life has brought upon your life in Jesus' name. For my people committed two evils, they are forsaking the fountain of living waters and hewed them out, cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water. Look at verse 17. It says, hast thou not procured this unto thyself? All this suffering, Christ would have removed them if you were not halting between two opinions. Have you not procured this unto thyself, in that thou hast forsaken the Lord thy God when he led thee by the way? Look at chapter 30 there, in chapter 30 of Jeremiah, verse 15. Why criest thou for thine affliction? Thy sorrow is incurable for the multitude of thine iniquity, because thy sins were increased. I have done these things unto thee. But now, when you make up your mind, things are going to change. In your life, things are going to change. In your family, things are going to change. On your body, things are going to change. All the pains and all the calamity and all those evil things you have felt until this time, as you turn to the Lord and you say, idols no more, traditional religion no more, and the superficial religion no more. I give my heart, my life, everything I've got, I give to the Lord, things will change. Look at verse 17. In verse 17, for I will restore health unto thee. Unto who? I said unto who? I rejoice with you. All those things of the past, they call incurable disease, everything will go away tonight. For I will restore health unto thee. I will heal thee of thy wounds, says the Lord. Because he called thee an outcast, saying, this is Zion whom no man seeketh after. And then in verse 22, look at verse 22, and ye shall be my people. Where are the people? Ye shall be my people. I say, where are the people? You will belong to God. And when you belong to God, no Satan, no sickness, no evil will touch your life again in Jesus' name. And I will be your God. Your God. Who is that? Your God. Your God. You will not belong to God and Satan at the same time. Amen. You will not belong to God and secret cult at the same time. You will not be halting between two opinions. And he says, I will be your God. No more halting. I said no more halting. Let's come back now to our story. We're coming to point number two. Hearing with thoughtful observation and surrendering. Now, look at that. Hearing with observation. Hearing with thoughtful observation. As you have come, you have had all these testimonies, and you have seen the great things God is doing in our day. You have seen that he's working here in Port Harcourt at the site of the crusade now. He's working all over Nigeria. You have seen and heard their testimony. You have seen that he goes beyond Nigeria in different countries of Africa. You have heard testimonies. You have heard testimonies from Europe. You have heard testimonies from America. You have heard from Australia. You have heard from India. You have heard from Asia. When you hear, you have thoughtful observation. You say, if God can do this in our day, that means the age of miracle has not passed. That means God, who sees me here, and he saw all those other people here, you are very thoughtful. You meditate on what you are hearing. Thoughtful observation. And you say, if that is so, I surrender to the Lord. As you surrender to the Lord, miracles will take place in your life. You'll be a child of God, and then his power, his strength, and every miracle you desire will be following after you day by day. Look at 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 22. They heard, they observed, they were thoughtful, they surrendered. Then said Elijah unto the people, I only remain a prophet of the Lord. But Baal's prophets are 450 men. Verse 23, it says, let them therefore give us two bullocks, and let them choose one bullock for themselves, and cut it in pieces, and lay it on wood, and put no fire under, and I will dress the other bullock and lay it on wood and put no fire under. Verse 24, and call ye on the name of the gods, and I will call on the name of the Lord, and the God that answereth by fire, let him be God. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. It is well spoken. Now, look at all the places you have gone seeking healing and deliverance and the exorcism that is driving the evil spirit out, and they give you something to drink and something to swallow, and they tell you to roll on the ground, and they tell you to kneel on the sand, and then they say whatever they want to say. You go back home the same. Everything is still the same. But look at the other side. Without throwing anything at you, without rubbing your forehead, and without doing anything, Jesus said, where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there in their midst. Christ is still alive. And to prove that he's still alive, we say, Lord Jesus, you're still alive, and you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. Look at your child there. Look at your creature there. Look at the believer there. Touch them, heal them, and then he does it. Is Christ dead or alive? Is Christ impotent or powerful? Is Christ able or unable? Able. You hear those testimonies and you sing. And because of that thoughtful observation, you surrender. Now, all those prophets of Baal, they did everything they wanted to do. They jumped on the altar. They caught themselves. They spoke in some languages, people don't understand. They were in ecstasy. And there was a great noise. And nothing happened. And Elijah said, wake him up. If it's a God, Elijah said, if he's gone on a journey, bring him back. And they shouted more, and nothing happened. Now Elijah said, all right, you've done your bit, come aside. Look at verse 36 now. In verse 36, and it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice that Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, he didn't jump, he didn't spin around, he didn't do any gymnastics, he didn't do any acrobatic display, he just stood there and said, God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am thy servant, and that I have done all these things according to thy word. Think, you hear with thoughtful observation. You see that everything we have done here is in the plain. We're here before you. You hear the singing, and you hear all the people testifying, and you see the doctor that is examining them and is saying, this is what we found out. And then you hear other people that after they were healed, they went for medical checkup and they brought their medical result. And they said, we were at this point, but now after the prayer, I went to check up, look at the result. Why don't you listen to that and observe thoughtfully and then surrender yourself? And so Elijah said that I have done all these things according to thy word. In verse 37, it says, hear me, O Lord, hear me, that these people may know that thou art the Lord God, and that thou hast turned their heart back again. All the testimonies we're hearing, all the good things the Lord has done, is so that as you hear and think and observe and surrender, you will know that the Lord is God and that he has turned your heart back again unto himself. Look at verse 38. In verse 38, then the fire of the Lord fell. Somebody shout a great amen. Then the fire of the Lord fell. Tonight, as he has done in all the other days, the fire of God will fall. It will burn away every chaff out of your life, every sickness out of your life, every infirmity out of your life. All the devil's property that lodged there in your life, the Lord will bring a total extermination. Burn them out tonight in Jesus' name. And consumed the burnt sacrifice and the wood and the stone and the doors, and licked up the water that was in the trench. Tonight is your night. Tonight is my night. Look at verse 39. In verse 39, when all the people saw it, it wasn't something that, you know, only the initiated could see. Only the people they have spoken to in the private, that, you know, when you go there, then say, I see. No, there's no private thing here, and there's no manipulation here. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces, and they said, the Lord, he is the God. The Lord, he is the God. The God that is able. The God that answers prayer. The God that saves the soul. The God that takes bad luck away. The God that turns your life around. He, the God of heaven, is the God. He has come to visit you. He will do it in your life in Jesus' name. Job chapter 42, reading from verse 2. I know. Job chapter 42, verse 2. I know that thou canst do everything. He said, I know. And the children of Israel, when they saw the fire falling down, and Elijah did not strike any match, did not put any artificial there, this is fire from heaven, healing from heaven, deliverance from heaven, power from heaven. Now Job said, Job had been down from chapter 1. Of Job, the devil ravaged his family, the devil destroyed his farm, everything collapsed. Chapter 2, the devil visited again, and everything was totally gone. And then even his body, there was sickness. And then in chapter 3, the friends came, they could only talk philosophy. They could only talk history. They could only talk religion. And they talked and talked and talked. We're not looking for talk. We're looking for miracle. Miracle has come tonight. I said miracle has come tonight. And then after they spoke and spoke and spoke, philosophy came in, religion came in, history came in, but no solution. Then God himself spoke to Job and said, were you there when I made this? Were you there when that happened? And then Job said, now I know. When you come to the point that you know that God is able and that God will roll that mountain away tonight, it will happen. I know that thou canst do everything. Everything in my life, you can do everything. Everything I have lost, you can bring everything back to me. My body that is sick, you can bring healing to my body. And then all my property that was burnt up in fire, you can't bring back that property. All my children that are lost, you can give me other children to replace them. I know that thou canst do everything, and that no thought can be withholding from thee. Look at now in verse 10. Verse 10 tells us, verse 10, Job chapter 42, verse 10, and the Lord turned the captivity of Job. And the Lord turns your captivity tonight. When he prayed for his friends, and the Lord gave Job, and the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. I welcome you to the blessing of God. I welcome you to the superabundance of God tonight in Jesus' name. Let's look at point three now. Point three is the healing for the truly obedient supplicant. The healing for the truly obedient supplicant. As these people saw when Elijah prayed and he said, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, let the people know that I've done this according to your word. And then the fire fell. Look at verse 41. In verse 41, 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 41. And Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink, because all the problems of the past is to him vanishing away. For there is a sound of abundance of rain. There is a sound of abundance of rain. Now, only Elijah heard that sound of abundance of rain. Ahab did not hear. Jezebel did not hear. The servants of Ahab did not hear. Even the servant of Elijah did not hear. But whether other people hear or not, your miracle is definite tonight. There is a sound of abundance of rain. Not only rain, abundance of rain in your life. Abundance of supply. Abundance of provision. Abundance of miracle. Look at verse 42. In verse 42, and Ahab went up to eat and to drink. Elijah said, Ahab, go and eat and drink. There's an abundance, the sound of the abundance of rain. Ahab, of all people, even though he did not hear the sound of abundance of rain, he knew this prophet who prayed and fire came down. Whatever he tells me now, I will do, because he hears what I cannot hear. If Ahab could act like that, how about you? You are better than Ahab now. Am I right? You are better than Jezebel. Am I right? If Ahab could go up and eat, and the 3.5 years of famine is coming to an end now. He didn't see the vision. He didn't hear any voice from heaven. Only Elijah heard, and he believed Elijah. As you believe the prophet, the man of God, you believe the one that the Lord has sent you tonight, miracle will happen in your life. So Ahab went up to eat and to drink, and Elijah went up to the top of Carmel, and he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees. Now, Elijah, that great prophet, at his own time, that's how he prayed. But then later, a greater than Elijah, what's his name? Jesus is come now. And when Jesus prayed, he didn't cast himself down Elijah did that, but Jesus is the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld the glory as of the glory of the only begotten Son, full of grace and full of truth. He doesn't cast himself down now. All he does now is look up and said, Father, I know you have heard me already, but because of the people who are here, I say these words, Lazarus, come forth. What happened? He came forth. But Elijah, that's how he prayed. That's how we pray now. We're disciples of Christ. We're following after Christ. And we just speak the word. Speak the word only. And my servant shall be healed. You are healed tonight. You are saved tonight. You are delivered tonight. It is confirmed in your life in Jesus' name. Verse 43. In verse 43, and he said to his servants, go up now and look towards the sea. Elijah said, I've heard the sound of abundance of rain. I know an abundance of rain, showers coming down. But my servant, go and check up. Go and see. And he went up and he looked and said, there is nothing. There is nothing. You know, after the prayer, they will say, check up. Just like Elijah said to his servants, go and find out. And he came back and he said, I've gone to check and there is nothing. You know, some people, when they check for the first time like that, and nothing, they see nothing, they're on to the bus stop. But Elijah said, go again. Check again. You must see something tonight. Check up again. Second time, nothing. No, you didn't see well. Go and check up again. The third time, and he came back and said, nothing. Elijah was so sure. God had said in verse 1, I sent rain upon the whole earth. Verse 1. And now we've gone through all the verses and we come almost to the end of the chapter. What God has said in verse 1 must take place before the end of your chapter. So that's why Elijah said, go the fourth time. He said, I see nothing. What kind of eyes do you have? When we say check up, that tumor is gone. That cancer is gone. That infirmity is gone. So Elijah will not give up. He said, go again. Fifth time, nothing. Six times, nothing. He said, complete the cycle. Seven times. Naaman dipped himself in the water seven times, Old Testament. When he dipped the first time, the problem was still there. Second time, problem there. When he did the seventh time, perfection, total time. Everything was totally clean, and his flesh was like the flesh of a little child. Look at Jericho walls. They went round once, nothing. Second time, nothing. Third time, nothing. On the seventh day, they went around seven times, and they shouted of victory. The walls came down. Your walls must come down. Anything standing between you and the power of God on this final day, you will not go without a miracle. And then look at verse 44. In verse 44, and it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea, like a man's hand, little cloud. We're looking for showers, but we only have a little feeling. We're looking for rivers, and we're looking for rain. We're looking for abundance. We're looking for superabundance, and we only see a little hand here. That's enough. I say that's enough. It's an indication that the abundance now has come. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot, get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. An avalanche of miracles. Multiple miracles upon your life. And then in verse 45 says, and it came to pass, it must come to pass in your life. The prophecy of the word will come to pass in your life. The salvation that is provided will come to pass in your life. The miracle of today, the greatest of miracles, will come to your life. It will come to pass in your life. It came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great rain, great salvation. Where are you? Great healing. Where are you? Great miracle. Where are you? Abundance tonight. Super abundance tonight. And the Lord is bringing it upon your life. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. Salvation is real and is coming from heaven. Righteousness is real and is coming from heaven. Forgiveness is real and is coming from heaven. He will take all the guilt of your past life. He'll take everything away. Amen. You want that great salvation, great forgiveness, great freedom, great redemption, and it's coming upon you now, wherever you are. Thank you. You're already raising up your hand. Wherever you are, raise up that hand. Salvation, righteousness, redemption, forgiveness coming upon your life. Today, it will come as a reality in your life in Jesus' name. You're raising up your hand. Please stand up. It's yours now. It is yours now. Where are you? It is yours now. The Lord already has told you, choose life and you will live. Some people say, I don't know whether salvation is for me or not. It's for everyone. Choose life. Choose blessing. Choose salvation and you will live. Raise up your hand and stand up in all the places where you are, any city, any local church where you're congregated together and we're connected together now. That salvation of the Lord without a shadow of doubt is coming upon your life. Online, anywhere, everywhere is coming. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for all those who have raised up their hands and they indicate they are not going to halt between two opinions anymore. Jesus, who died on the cross, will be their Savior, their only Savior. I pray as they surrender their lives to you now, save them, everyone without exception, in Jesus' name. Confirm your salvation in their hearts. Thank you, Lord. I know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. As we have asked, and you have asked, and you have believed, it is done. We call on our state overseer here, River State, and help us with the counseling now. And then after this short time, I come back. There's going to be multiplied miracle upon every life, even tonight, in Jesus' name.
You are welcome to the kingdom of God. Give your full name, your telephone number, and all that is required on the form. As you do that, you will continue in the blessing of the Lord. As you receive more help from the church, from our pastor, by the grace of God, counselors, attend to every one of them everywhere. In the overflow, attend to them in all our locations. Let's attend to every one of them. Write in capital letter, block letters, so that we can read what you've written. The rest of us, get prepared for torrential rain. It's going to come upon you tonight. You will see it. You will testify. It's for you. Counselors, the moment you finish, you let us know. For those watching us online, you just gave your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. After the pastor's message now, this evening, visit the link showing on the screen now and fill the form so we can assist you further in your new walk with Christ. Also, in that same link, click to it. There is a gift for you, a book written by the pastor that will help you, edify you, build you up. So please make sure you get to the link. As you do that, your blessings will never cease. Also, those listening to us through radio and television, please send your name, your phone number, and your email address via SMS or WhatsApp to this telephone number, +234 705 278 1389. I repeat, +234 705 278 1389. There will be a special online banquet for all those watching online who gave their lives to the Lord. Details about this will be sent to you. A pastor is delighted to have you join this special banquet.